check, 1, 2. Mic check, 1, 2.
It's good.
Scripture today is a very short verse, from Job, the 28th chapter. And then God said to man, "The fear of the Lord, that is wisdom. And to shun evil is understanding." Here is the word of the Lord. If you could do me a favor and invite the kids, the puppets out, that would be wonderful. On the count of three, one, two, three. Puppets, come out.
Mo, what's wrong?
I'm mad at God.
You can't be mad at God.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. The Bible says I can. It's okay to get mad at God.
Where does it say that?
In the Psalms.
What does it say?
My God, why have you forgotten about me?
Aren't those the words that Jesus said when he was on the cross?
Yes, they are.
And these are the same words in the Psalms?
Yes, they are. These are the words said both by the Psalms and by Jesus. So they must be okay.
Don't you think God will get mad if you are mad at him?
No, I don't.
How come?
Any relationships has it angry. Because God doesn't mind if you're angry, it's better to be angry than to ignore.
So you're saying God just doesn't want us to ignore him?
Yes, any relationship has its happy and angry stuff.
I guess so.
It's okay to get angry.
So what are you angry about anyways?
I heard that the liverwurst has disappeared.
No, it hasn't.
That's what I heard.
Well, I bet you heard it from Benny, and he tried to trick me earlier.
Really?
Yes.
That's a relief. Can we go check in if we can eat some?
You bet.
Cool. Goodbye, everyone.
And have a great week.
Let us pray. Gracious God, thank you for being here tonight. Lord, be here. Help us to hear all that you have to say for us. Guide us, and also keep us safe on the road on the way home. We pray this in your name. Amen. So tonight we're going to talk about Job. The scripture, that short piece of scripture, is from the book of Job. And it's a scripture that actually was used at my sister's funeral quite a few years ago. So it's a scripture that means a lot to me. But we're going to start talking about Job itself. Job had his life kind of unravel before him. And Job had three friends who weren't the greatest friends. And we're going to see why they weren't the greatest friends. Well, Job had a number of bad things that happened to him. First and foremost, Job had property. He had a lot of property, and all of a sudden, he lost most of that property. Some of it burned, some of it flooded, all of it was gone. And his friends showed up and asked him, "What did you do wrong?" They said to Job, "Job, you must have done something wrong, otherwise these bad things wouldn't have happened to you. It's your fault." And Job kept insisting, "I didn't do anything wrong." But they kept insisting that he must have. This is what happened at that time. When bad things happen, it must have been your fault. We can see that still creeping into culture today. Well, after all the property stuff, then came his family. He lost people in his family. And once again, those same friends showed up and asked him, what did you do wrong? What did you do wrong that your property would have fallen away? Your family would have died and left you. What did you do wrong? And once again, Job said, I didn't do anything. I did not do anything wrong. But all the problems kept adding up. Then the wealth hit, and all of a sudden his money was gone, and it kept disappearing and disappearing. And once again, his friends came back and said, hey, Job, now we've talked to you before. You must have done something wrong. Each time, Job insisted he did nothing wrong. And then the last one hit. Job's health. Job started to get caught up in sores and disease. And even his friends who kept coming, come all the way to him. They got halfway and they would yell over, Job, you must have done something wrong. What did you do? Job kept admitting he did nothing wrong. Did nothing wrong. But you know those people, they kept getting into his head. They kept egging him on. So he's overwhelmed and listening to those friends, and finally he starts to think, I must have done something wrong. So he cries out to God and says, oh God, why? Why? What did I do wrong? In that time, God answers. God answers with fear the Lord. Now that doesn't sound like to us probably, is there anything wrong? All right, we'll keep going. It doesn't sound like the most motivational speech from God. Fear the Lord. Because what do we think about when we think about being afraid or fearful? We think about like a horror movie, and then we're supposed to be trembling when God comes near. But fear in the Bible, it doesn't translate well into our culture. The word should be better translated as remind yourself that God is in charge. It's not just to be afraid of God, but to start reminding yourself that God is in charge. Because what would happen if we reminded ourselves that God was in charge? We could look at all those things again. If you remind yourself that God is in charge from the get-go, from the beginning, and you know that you're not going to understand everything, if God is in charge, just like we're supposed to fear and love our parents, we remind ourselves that our parents are in charge. And we don't always understand everything that they're trying to get us to do. Then when the bad things happen, when we have property loss, and we live in an area where property does get lost, around here it's probably hail damage, or sometimes flooding, maybe it's a forest fire. But when we get these calamities and they happen, and we remind ourselves that God is in charge, and when we have family problems, and we lose our loved ones, and we wonder what happened, why, and we still continue to remind ourselves God is in charge. And we have money problems. And we wonder when the bills are going to get paid or where our next meal is coming from. but still remind ourselves God's in charge. And this is God's world. And this one isn't a if it's going to happen. For all of us, this is going to be a when it happens. When we have health problems. When health doesn't go the way we'd like it to, when we're hurting. Some of us are lucky enough to wait till we're older. Some happen sooner than others. And when we lose friends due to health, and we wonder why we're losing a friend, as Sydney said so eloquently last week, she was a ray of light and shouldn't have gone. But we remind ourselves that God is in charge. Things seem to fit a whole lot better. I don't know what's going on in your life, but maybe you find yourself overwhelmed at some points of time, quite a lot like Job. Maybe things don't fit all that well, and you're wondering, why, God, why? Start by saying, I know that God is in charge. And maybe things will fit just a little bit better. May the peace that surpasses all understanding, may it be with you and now and always. Amen.
I was born by the river in a little tent, and oh, just like a river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know change is gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, and I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. I go to the movies and I go downtown, but someone always telling me, don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. And when I go to my brother, I say, brother, help me please. But he ends up knocking me right back down on my knees. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there, y'all, beyond the sky. Been a long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Thank you so much.
Just a couple quick reminders before we move into our time of prayer. There are tickets still available for Daddy-Daughter Dance, including being able to go online and purchase them. And also, if you haven't checked out the silent auction, please do that as well. We join our hearts in prayer. Let us pray. Living God, when two or three are gathered together, you promise that you will be here with us. Thank you for being here tonight. Thank you, O God, for those who share their gifts of music through instrument and voice, so that we are able to celebrate our trust and glory in you. Continue to help us to be in awe of you, to see you in our neighbors, to see you in all of creation. Thank you, O God, that you are in charge. Help us to remember that you are with us, O God, in good times and in bad times. And we know that when we hit that dark patch, that you promise that change is coming and your light in Christ will shine through. Be with us as we find ways to continue to be a caring and connected faith community, knowing that all we do is in your glory. We pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's join our voices together to pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Please stand for the closing song.
Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Love and there.